Today we will see English Pari textbook of 3rd standard CBSE syllabus. This is of Macmillan's Education. And next we will see Dreams and Fantasy, Chapter 6, The Elves and the Shoemaker. Chapter 6, The Elves and the Shoemaker. Warm up. We have helped many people, animals and things every day. Form groups and discuss how they help you. Your family, mother gives me food and clothes. Father helps with homework. Your friends, your neighbors, your teacher, animals, trees. Reading. This story is about a poor shoemaker whose life changes when magic happens. Let's read to find out more. Once upon a time, there lived a poor shoemaker. Though he was honest and hardworking, he never had enough money. He and his wife ran the household with great difficulties. Sometimes all they had to eat was a piece of bread. The shoemaker saved some money and finally had enough to buy a piece of leather. He could make only one pair of shoes with it. He decided to make the shoes the next day, so he prepared the leather that night and left it ready on the table for his workroom. He slept happily that night, thinking of the pair of shoes he would make the next day. In the morning, after he had a slice of toast for breakfast, he entered his workroom. On his work table stood a beautiful pair of fancy shoes. The shoemaker was completely taken aback. He rushed to call his wife. When he told her what he had seen, she could not believe him. So the shoemaker brought his wife to the room and she was amazed to see the shoes. The shoemaker took the shoes in his hands, admiring the neat and tidy stitches. He had tears in his eyes. He thanked God for this miracle and set the pair on the window shelf. Taken aback, very surprised. A rich merchant was passing by the shoemaker's window. When he spotted the attractive pair of shoes, he went inside and bought them, paying a handsome price. After such a long time, the shoemaker and his wife had a proper meal that day. That evening, the shoemaker brought enough leather to make two pair of shoes. He cut and shaped the shoes with great love and care. By the end of the evening, he was tired. He laid everything out and left the room. He thought that he could come back the next morning to complete the work. The next morning, the shoemaker woke up early. He bathed and prayed, ate his humble breakfast, and then stepped into the room where he worked. Lo and behold, once again he found two stylish pairs of shoes waiting for him on his work table. With a prayer on his lips and a tear in his eye, the shoemaker once again thanked God for his fortune. That day, two more rich clients bought the shoes at the very good price. Again, the shoemaker brought some more leather and left it in the room. The next day, he found four pairs of attractive new shoes on his work table. This went on for some time. Humble, here, simple. Soon, the shoemaker became quite rich. He could buy lots of leather and make many pair of shoes at once. Before Christmas, the shoemaker's wife suggested they find out who was helping them with the shoes that night. So the couple hid behind the curtain of the workroom and stood in absolute silence. Right after midnight, the window opened and two small elves entered the room. They were dressed in dirty and torn clothes. They sang and hung to themselves and worked on the pieces of leather that were sitting on the table. The shoemaker and his wife were so grateful that they nearly came out of their hiding place and thanked them. But they did not move so as not to scare the elves. The next day, the shoemaker and his wife cut bits of clothes and made little clothes for the elves. That night, they put the new clothes on the work table and left the room. After a while, the elves came as usual looking for the piece of leather that the shoemaker would have left behind. But instead, they found two new sets of clothes for themselves. The elves were extremely happy. They took the clothes and jumped through the window singing and dancing merrily. The shoemaker and his wife thanked them silently. The shoemaker now had enough money and he could employ a few men to work for him. He was never poor again. Though the elves never came back, the shoemaker and his wife knew they were somewhere helping other people. Adapted from the original story by Brothers Grimm. Reading comprehension. Fill in the form with information about the story. All about the story, title, people, setting, what was the problem, how was the problem solved, what happened in the end. You can write it over here. Next, answer these questions. When the shoemaker was able to save some money, what did he buy? Who saw the shoes in the window? How did the shoemaker and his wife found out who was helping them? What were the elves wearing? What did the elves find on their last night? Think and answer. Why do you think the elves made shoes for the shoemaker? Why did the shoemaker and his wife make clothes for the elves? Values and life skills. Read the situations and discuss the questions with your elbow partner. Reena had brought a new toy car. When she was playing with it, Rohit ran past and broke the car. What do you think is the problem here? How do you think Reena felt when her car was broken? What should Rohit do now? Tarun was playing in the playground when Tia pushed him hard. Tarun has hurt his knee. He is very upset. What do you think is the problem here? How do you think Tarun felt when he was pushed? What should Tia do now? Payal had got a delicious cake from home, but she doesn't want to share it with her friends Jyoti, as the two had fought last afternoon. When Payal shares the cake with everyone else, Jyoti feels upset. What do you think is the problem here? How do you think Jyoti feels? What should Payal do now? Vocabulary. Read these phrases. A pair of shoes, a pinch of salt, a loaf of bread, a bar of chocolate. What do these phrases denote? They tell us about a number or the amount of something. Some nouns such as shoes, salt, bread, chocolate, honey and furniture cannot be counted. For example, we do not say 10 salts, 5 honeys, etc. We call such nouns as uncountable nouns. Now look at the picture and circle the correct options. For each, blob of butter, cake of soap, a slice of cake, a cloud of steam, a pile of books, a scoop of ice cream. Complete the crossword with the clues. You can complete this activity. Grammar, read these phrases. Conjunction. In a little village, there lived a shoemaker and his wife. They had money for bread but no money for leather. They could either buy food or buy leather to make shoes. The elves started helping them, so they became rich. They made clothes for the elves because the elves had helped them so much. Conjunctions are the words that join two halves of a sentence. Words such as and, but, or, because, so, for are conjunctions. Color the sentences, pieces in the same color to tell the story of the elves and the shoemaker. One has been done for you. Can complete this. Speaking, in the story, the elves helped the shoemaker, but they did not accept anything in return. Working in groups, discuss. Do you think we should help each other more? Why should we help each other? You can complete this activity. Next comes writing. Do one good turn a day for someone in need and write about it in your diary. You may refer to the sample given on page 49. You can complete. Next comes my word bank. Find these words from the story. Write a synonym for each. Household, family, difficulty, hardship, attractive, pretty, suggested, proposed, helpless, incapable. Yes, this completes the chapter. Thank you.